So let's use these equations now to study the lift on the tail and to see what we can learn from that. So I've copied down our two equations. So we've got our lift equation here and our pitching moment equation. Remember, both of these have to be satisfied for the aircraft to be trim. And now let's actually start by looking at the right-hand equation here, the pitching moment, and let's look at the case where LW is greater than zero. Now remember, LW, I'm just going to draw a little picture up here. We've got our main wing and our horizontal, and then we put the center of gravity in front of the main wing, and we said that LW is the distance aft that the main wing, or the aerodynamic center of the main wing, sits from the center of gravity, and then of course L sub H is the distance to the horizontal tail. Okay, so just a reminder, that's what our free body diagram looks like. So let's look at the case where LW is greater than zero. So this first term, the pitching moment the pitching moment on the main wing is usually negative, okay? Because usually we have positive camber on the main wing. So I'll just draw kind of a camber line in here. And so positive camber tends to create a negative pitching moment. So that's going to be a negative value. The pitching moment on the horizontal can be positive or negative, depending on if that horizontal has positive camber or negative camber or zero camber. Let's look at the case for zero camber here for just a minute and say that it's zero. And so there is no sign then for the pitching moment on the horizontal. Now, actually, let me back up because if we have a positive elevator deflection, if we have a positive elevator deflection, then that will also create a negative pitching moment. So anyway, that can bounce around, but let's just say that the pitching moment is zero right now. We're just going to ignore that pitching moment on the horizontal. It's usually rather small anyway, compared to the effects of these other things. Okay, so now let's look at the next term here. This next term is the effect from the lift coefficient of the main wing, and that of course is positive, and then we said the LW was positive, and so this is going to be a negative contribution to pitching moment. So you can see where this is going, maybe, that basically if LW is greater than zero, we've got to have a way for this last term to give us some positive pitching moment in order to trim this aircraft. Well, L sub H is positive by default because that's the distance after the CG that the horizontal stabilizer sits. And of course that in our example here has to be behind the center of gravity because it's an aft horizontal stabilizer. So that's positive. SH over SW, of course, is gonna be a positive term. Eta sub H is going to be a positive term. So all in order for this final term to actually give us a positive number, our lift coefficient CL has to be, or on the horizontal, has to be less than zero, okay? And that will give us a net positive term down here that can be used then to satisfy this equation that our all of our pitching moment has to sum to zero. So you can see basically what we've learned here is that if the center of gravity is out in front of the main wing, meaning that L sub W is positive, then the lift on the horizontal has to be negative in order to trim out this aircraft, okay? And that's maybe a little bit counterintuitive if this is the first time that you're hearing about this. People call this downlift on the horizontal. It's not uncommon for the tail to have to carry some negative lift over some portion of the flight. Now, that's not necessarily required at all points in the flight envelope. And so let's look, for example, what if L sub W was less than zero? In other words, if the center of gravity sat behind the aerodynamic center of the main wing, well, the first term is still gonna be negative. The second term, we're still gonna neglect here and just say that's zero. The third term now would then be positive because L sub W would be negative, making the complete term there positive. And so in that case, this could actually be positive or negative. We'll say that That allows lift on the horizontal to be greater than zero if we wanted it to. We can actually, we could play with the location or, you know, the magnitude here of L sub W and the magnitudes back here, the lift coefficient, and to trim the aircraft. So in this case, L sub, or the lift on the horizontal could be greater than zero which would produce a negative pitching moment there. Okay, so let's look at one specific case, and this is first of all, there are some pros and cons of having positive or negative lift on the horizontal. First of all, negative lift, of course, we don't want to carry negative lift on the tail for obvious reasons, and that's, if we come back over to this equation here, we have to produce enough lift on the aircraft to offset the weight of the aircraft, okay? Well, if the horizontal stabilizer is producing negative lift, then that means that the lift coefficient on the main wing, or the lift on the main wing, has to overcome not only the weight of the aircraft, but also the negative lift on the horizontal tail. So it has to produce more lift. Well, that produces more induced drag. And besides that, carrying negative lift on a horizontal also produces induced drag. And so we've got quite a bit more induced drag here than really is necessary. If we could somehow make this so that we weren't carrying any load on a horizontal, then the lift on the main wing would just simply be offsetting the weight of the aircraft, okay? Well, let's look at this example where the lift coefficient is actually positive on the horizontal. So now we've got positive lift here, positive lift there. So the horizontal is offsetting some of the weight of the aircraft. Of course, most of the weight is being offset by the lift on the main wing. And so that's not a bad situation to be in. The only drawback really to that is that is the efficiency by which we're producing that lift. Usually the main wing is a pretty high aspect ratio wing, and from our study of wings, we understand that a higher aspect ratio means that it produces lift more efficiently. It creates less induced drag for the amount of lift that it's generating. Well, usually the horizontal stabilizer has a lower aspect ratio, and so it's producing lift at a lower efficiency. And so again, if we wanted to minimize drag in this case, then actually we want the main wing to be carrying as much of the lift as possible. And in the ideal situation, again, the horizontal stabilizer would be carrying zero lift. Okay, so to make something really efficient, we want to basically minimize the positive or negative lift on the horizontal tail. And in the ideal sense, we would want that to go to zero. So let's look at that case. What if we could set CLH on the horizontal tail, the lift coefficient, to zero? Well, the first equation, our lift equation, just simplifies then to that the lift coefficient on the main wing is equal to our weight coefficient times cosine gamma, right? So in this case, our main wing is offsetting the weight of the aircraft. And then our second equation here, our pitching moment equation, also simplifies if the lift on the horizontal is zero. So what we'd get there is that Cm equals Cm from the wing plus SH over SW, C bar H over C bar W, eta sub H times Cmh minus LW over C bar W times CL wing, okay? So we've dropped out this last term here, the lift coefficient on the horizontal, because we said that that's zero, and so we're left with this. Well, what we can do now is that actually we can solve for the location of the main wing relative to the center of gravity that would allow us to satisfy this equation, this pitching moment equation. So let's just rearrange this equation and solve for LW over C bar wing. So this is a non-dimensional length, a distance relative to the mean chord of the wing. And I'm also going to substitute in this CW cosine gamma for the lift on the main wing, okay, because those are equal. So if we just solve this equation for the location of the main wing, what we get is that CMW plus SH over SW, C bar H over C bar wing, times eta sub H, CMH, divided by CW cosine gamma. Okay, so this equation is kind of interesting to look at here for just a minute. So this tells us that the location of the wing here, normalized by the mean chord of the main wing, if that is equal to this expression here, then we will get zero lift on the horizontal tail. And so so we can figure out, you know, what's the pitching moment of the main wing, what's the pitching moment of the horizontal. You know, these are all basically constants that are known. And for a trim condition, if we're trimming this for some cruise velocity, then we'd probably want the pitching moment on the horizontal to be the case where our elevator deflection is zero. Okay, so we would know what that pitching moment is for the airfoil with the zero elevator deflection. We know the pitching moment on the main wing. And then we're going to be able to trim this for some, notice in the denominator here that this trim condition or the location here is a strong function of our operating condition. So our weight coefficient depends on our velocity and the weight of the aircraft and the density. So this could change with altitude. This could change with velocity of the aircraft or with the weight of the aircraft as we burn off fuel. And then cosine gamma, of course, is our climb angle. And so it will change as we change our climb angle. So really, all we can do is choose a single operating condition where this equation then would be satisfied. Once we've set the location of the wing relative to the center of gravity, we really can't move that. You know, now we can move the center of gravity actually by how we schedule burning fuel and things like that. But for our purposes here, this is kind of a constant. You know, this is the location of the wing relative to the center of gravity. And we can really only choose one location or one operating condition that will produce zero lift on the tail. So we probably want to choose our cruise condition where we're going to be spending most of our time. You know, this is the altitude and the velocity and the weight that we're going to be cruising at most of the time. And then we can set this, the location of this wing relative to the center of gravity, so that in that condition that we have zero lift on the tail. Now, when we go off condition, you know, if we speed up or slow down or change our altitude or a slightly different weight, then of course we're going to start to incur some lift on the horizontal tail, either positive or negative, in order to trim the aircraft. And so most aircraft do end up spending some time or some portions of their envelope with negative lift on their tail. That's a very common thing. But it also just depends on how you've designed this and whether or not you've been able to really tweak out, you know, the location of the center of gravity relative to the main wing in order to minimize the lift on the tail. That's usually what you want to do, because lift on the tail, positive or negative, doesn't matter, usually hurts the efficiency of the aircraft. Of course, negative is worse than positive. So anyway, that's just an insight, some insights we can gain about lift on the tail from these two equations. And now we're going to dig into some more trim conditions.